Hi sir, good morning. Amit
Yeah, hi Amit.
here. Sir, just wanted to ask, before enrolling for this course, I asked few of my friends, whether do we need any coding background?
Okay.
So they said, yeah, we do need a lot of coding background and tools like Python, R, Tableau. We must be excel in these things. So is it true?
No,
No.
it's not. The reason being, you will be, getting to know all these tools within the course. And again, I am not a Python coder. Like, I used to do very minimal coding. Even SQL is as simple as writing and learning English kind of language. It's as simple as that. So, I have learned all the languages, whether it's R, Python, or anything here only. Nothing like before joining the course, you don't need anything. Within the course only, you have all these courses, so you'll get to learn. So don't worry about that.
Okay, sir. Thank you. And another thing, any mathematical course would you like to suggest which I should go through before joining in, before getting into this PGDB?
No, dude, just clear the exam, get in, admission into the course. You will learn. You will have a whole, hell lot of courses to learn, and then you will just enjoy the life for now because you will be learning a lot. So for now, just chill and clear this exam.
All right, sir. That was so helpful. Thank you so much.
Yeah.
Yeah, Abhishek.
Yeah. Hello. Thank you,
Hi.
sir. So my question was, normally, how does the career of a PGDPA student progress? So, for example, for an MBA student, we know like they go on to become like marketing heads or even CXOs, CEOs, etc. So for PGDPA, because it is analytics specific, so how do you sort of rise in a company, let's say 10 years into the future of sorts?
It's similar to an so if I say, like, if you're comparing to an MBA guy, it's similar to that only because again it depends on what kind of industry you join in. So I know guys within our course, like from our batch, who are right now AVPs in firms like JP Morgan and everything. So again, it depends on what kind of career you are choosing. Even some of guys has opened startups also. So there, as such, there's no path per se. But yeah, if you're
So
talking
is it
about
like
consulting, you can go till director level also. So it's about, okay, the PGDB course sets you in a upper man top management. So starting position of top management. It sets you up from where an MBA guy starts. The only edge that you have over an MBA guy is you have the tech skills also. So that helps you a lot when you're getting promotion and everything.
So future transitions into fully managerial roles away from pure analytics is also like possible of sorts.
Yeah. That depends again on you. So like I have transitioned that into that role, but again, it depends on you. But what's the point if you are not doing analytics? So again, the reason is because if you are a PGDBA guy, you will be known for analytics. Everyone will look to you for analytics. So managerial thing will be there, but again, you should have that knowledge of analytics and everything. You will have to work on that.
Thank you, sir.
Yeah.
Shashank?
Hi, sir. Good morning. This is Shashank here.
Good.
So I have a few queries. So my first query is, can we compare PGDBA versus doing experience in analytics, doing MOOCs and all?
No. Okay, the reason being, there is a difference between, learning from, again, I'm not saying people haven't done that, but companies kind of they look for degrees. Like, they look for these, tags, degrees, and PGDBA is known. It has actually proven, people are there who have proven their skills. MOOCs is something like, it depends on you, right? So after all these MOOCs, you have to do some projects if you get those, and you have to prove. If you are being selected for PGDBA, you have already proven that you are among, the elite kind of which people they are looking, the analytics people. So that's why you just can't compare both of them. one is a like very difficult task. Even the PGDB is also like a lot of a task. But yeah, that's what I think.
I think also what Ankit said, the point is that if you are already placed in like higher CTC bracket, I mean, you can do MOOCs and learn the front end part. If you want to thoroughly understand what is behind the models and how the mathematical models work, you need to start from scratch. And in CTC, you will be doing that with the help of pen and paper, right? Not with your computer. So at the beginning, you would be deriving everything from scratch. So that is where to learn everything, right? MOOCs kind of give you a front-end experience, like how the UI is, like how the models are getting deployed, not the back-end part. So for your client to understand what is going on, you would be needing that kind of information as well, right? To compare and provide them insights on models. And so that will help you a lot. Right, Ankit?
Yes. Can you hear me?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so was that clear or should I repeat that?
It was clear for me, sir.
Okay.
So, right. One more query I have is, like, can we compare PGDB with MTech Data Science or MBA Business Analytics or anything?
Ankit?
I'm not aware of, like, I have heard about all these courses, but again, PGDB is different in terms of it, you know, teaches you the management part also. When you say MTech or something, I think all those courses are very specific to data science. PGDB is not just specific. So it gives you an option. You can become a business analyst, you can become a data scientist, or you can become a totally, you know, management guy also. Again, it depends on you. It gives you that leverage based on your selection of electives and everything. So yeah, if compared to MTech, I won't say I would, but rest of the courses I'm not aware of. So again, Nitin, if you have any knowledge.
So mostly people doing MTech and like doing technical degree in analytics, they would be placed as a analyst or senior analyst, and their like career progress will be in that direction. But for PGDB guys, what Ankit said is like we have both the domains to explore. So we can jump to consulting, we can jump to consulting role as well as we can handle the analytics and like technical things, right? So that you would get an advantage because 1 year over here in this course, we get trained in management courses as well. So that will help you a lot.
Yes, sir.
Moving on. So one question at a time, please. So we are running out of time. We have 2-3 minutes. Sashank, are you done?
Yes, sir. I have one query, like last query. So regarding the fees, do you think like the increase in fees with respect to course, is it justified like that?
Oh, we are not. I mean, we cannot comment on that, right? So each IIM is increasing their fee and all. That's going to be there, right? So because the ROI is very high for this course particularly, I can say, right? In MBA, I mean, there is a chance of not getting placed, but in PGDB you will definitely get multiple opportunities, right? So it's kind of that only, risk and return. So I am no one to comment on that, but yes, if they are increasing the fee, ROI should be there in their mind.
Thank
and
you,
it's
sir.
Your perspective, Shashank, completely. I mean, if you're investing, you want return, right, on your investment. So if you think it's appropriate, I mean, you should jump into it. If you think it's not, I mean, why to invest in something that is not giving them?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, Manpreet.
Yeah, thanks. Hi, Ankit. Hi, Anjin. So my question is pertaining to what you just talked about. So you said that there were companies who were shortlisting candidates on the basis of their work experience, if I heard that right. So how much weightage is actually given to that criteria? That is one of my questions. Yes.
That depends again on the role, Manpreet. So it's not so, okay, a very good example of this is, like I'll just mention the name. The reason is this girl has like 1 year of experience. It was not also relevant to analytics. Manasvi Veligatla. Mm-hmm. And she was actually you know, selected at par with people who have that much experience, like around 3 to 4 years of experience. Again, it depends on a lot on how your interview is also going. Again, some companies might have that particular thing, so you can't help out with that. But again, companies like very good consulting companies, they do look for talent. So if you are PGDBA, you know, if you have done good in PGDBA, a lot of projects, and you have a very good profile as per the whole thing, I think experience should not matter that much. For me, it matters. Like I said, my grades weren't that good and I was not a bright student. So yeah, for me, it was kind of those things. But yeah, for me, experience worked. Yeah.
My grades aren't that great either, but currently I'm working as a data scientist at a Singapore-based startup. So, but it's only been a few months now, so I'm not sure how much will that be weighted upon. But yeah,
if you are a data scientist, it will be given weightage. Believe me. Like I was an engineer, like just a software engineer, and still they have given that weightage. So even a few months, they actually will give some weightage to that.
Okay, makes sense. Thank you so much.
Yeah. Next, Saksham.
Hello, sir. Actually, I have a question. Like, how was your interview experience with the PGDBA? Like, when you were getting admission into it?
I'll explain you this in very short. Like, so there were three people, again, each one from each institute. And they kind of ask questions in which they are like expertise. So the ISI guy has asked me to solve a integration and differentiation problem and a Fourier series. And at that time, I was actually prepared for that because we have to, you know, give an exam there also. IM guy usually asks those HR kind of questions, that how will you deal with these situations and, you know, why. If you are coming from why are you leaving the job and everything, all those kind of thing. And the IT guy is more like chill. For me, it was very chill. Like he's like, okay, do you know coding, wording? Okay, if not, then also it's okay. But what is exactly your background? And all those questions, like why so low marks in, you know, BTEC and everything. And I was like, yeah, not a great student and all those kind of thing. So it was a mixed interview. It was more of like, okay, I would say for me. Again, for the ISI guy, I kind of, the whatever problem he has given me, I solved all of them. So that was one point I think they got kind of impressed that, okay, fine. This guy knows at least, you know, what he's getting into. Because I actually in my profile said that, yeah, I like maths and stats. So, and I had scored some good marks. I was already admitted to ISI. So they expect all those kind of things from me. So it's again, what strength you mention. And in the interview, if they are asking you whether you are actually, you know, good in that or not. So yeah, that works out for me. Again, Nitin, your experience, how was it?
So as Sanket rightly said, so if you are talking about something which is your strength, they will definitely like put you on trial and they will test it out. If you are saying that this is your strength, that is something that you should prepare very well before the interview, right? And rest, like it all depends on how you take those questions, like how you dodge those questions, how you take answer those questions, and in which direction you are taking that interview. So, right? It could be very grilling, and if you talk in like a friendly manner and have a conversation, I mean, it will go in that direction about your knowledge and all. So we will prepare you for that during interview mock. So don't worry about it right now. Right. So anyone else apart from Sashidhar who has questions? Okay. Sashidhar, please go ahead. So this is our last question for the session and we will close this within like 1 or 2 minutes.
Good morning, sir. Sir, actually, I am from mechanical background. I have 3 years experience in mechanical background. Will it affect, if I get into PGDBA, will it affect in placements? I have totally irrelevant experience. I was working as manager in the projects. It's totally different from analytics.
Okay. Yeah.
But I'm interested in analytics, but I'm unable to do it because of my job. So
I didn't get, Sashidhar, like what exactly is the problem? Like, do you mean in
placements? If I in placements in PGDB, if I get admission in PGDB and in placements, will it affect? Because my 3 years experience is regarding a mechanical stream, but it is not nowhere related to analytics, nowhere related to software.
So again, there are a lot of people like who have come from NTPC, Bhel, all these government PSUs, and I know there is this one guy who has come from SBI. He like did a MBA from NITI and everything. Kya naam hai yaar us bande ka? He's right now in Daimler Trucks, like at a very good position, by the way. So again, nothing to worry about the experience thing, because you have learned something. When you are in job, you learn something. You learn how to deal with people. It's just that you have to show those things, because it's not just about always having that relevant experience means technical knowledge and all those things. You should tell that, okay, what exactly did you learn in job? You might have learned about people handling, communication skills, team handling, all those kind of things, which is needed when you are going for the other job also. So that might be not given that much, you know, compared to someone who has a relevant experience. Your experience might not be given that much weightage, but it will be given weightage. So don't worry about that.
Right.
So thank you, sir.
Just to add one point, so it depends like with what kind of company you're setting for, right? So if you're setting for cutting edge analytics driven company, I mean, they would prefer analytics. If you're setting for L&T, let's say, they would prefer someone who has knowledge in these things, mechanical domain basically, right? So it depends from company to company, and then you have analytics knowledge in your background, right? Which you have gone through the course, which you have learned through the course. So that will add up value, to whatever you have in your bag, right? Right, so guys, we are wrapping it up now, and thanks a lot, Ankit, for your time today. And thank you for coming over here and spending time with our students. Definitely, we will get in touch with you again, and we'll schedule another call to have your insights on how to go about PGDB and all.
Sure.
So, thank you to spend time this morning.
Thanks, Nitin, and thank you, everyone. And hope everyone did good, you know, do good in your interviews and everything. And all the best for your careers and the PGDBA interview.